high on a mountain above ancient Greece, Zeus was throwing a party. But it wasn't just any mountain. It was Mount Olympus, home of the gods. And it wasn't just any party. It was the biggest event of the year because Zeus and Hera, king and queen of the gods, were celebrating the birth of their son, Hercules. All the Olympian gods were there. They watched in amazement as baby Hercules grabbed Zeus by the finger and lifted the mighty god off his feet. Then he began to play with one of his father's lightning bolts.
Dear, keep those away from the baby.
Oh, he won't hurt himself. Let the kid have a little fun.
After the entertainment, it was time to open presents. The best one came from Zeus himself.
Well, let's see here. We'll take, yes, a little Cirrus, and, a touch of Nimbostratus, and a dash of Cumulus.
Shaping the clouds in his hands, Zeus formed a baby horse with wings.
His name is Pegasus, and he's all yours, son.
How sentimental.
Through the crowd stepped Hades, lord of the underworld.
So, Hades, you finally made it. How are things in the underworld?
Well, they're just fine. You know, a little dark, a little gloomy, and as always, hey, full of dead people. What are you going to do?
But Hades was secretly planning to defeat Zeus and take over the world. The only time to do it was in 18 years when the planets were perfectly aligned. There would be only one thing standing in his way then, a grown-up Hercules. The question was, how to get rid of him? Later that day, back in the underworld, Hades summoned his two demon helpers, Pain and Panic.
Pain? Panic? Got a little riddle for you. How do you kill a god?
I do not know! You can't. They're immortal.
Bingo! They're immortal. So, first you gotta turn the little sunspot mortal.
That night, as Zeus and Hera were sleeping, they heard a noise in the nursery. They rushed in and found Pegasus there, but no Hercules.
No!
As Zeus's roar echoed through the clouds, Pain and Panic flew back to Earth, clutching the baby between them.
Hurry! Let's just kill the kid and get it over with, okay?
Pain pulled out a bottle filled with a secret potion and offered it to the wailing baby.
Here you go, kid! A little Christian formula!
As Hercules drank, he began to lose his godlike glow.
Look at that! Changing. Can we do it now?
No. He has to drink the whole potion. Every last drop.
Who's there?
At the sound of the strange voice, Pain and Panic, well, panicked. They dropped the bottle and ran, hiding behind a rock. Down the nearby path stepped a kindly old man named Amphitryon, along with his wife, Alcmene.
Well, he must have been abandoned.
Amphitryon, for so many years we prayed to the gods to bless us with a child. Perhaps they've answered our prayers.
Pain and Panic, desperate to finish the job, turned themselves into a pair of deadly snakes and slithered toward the couple. But Hercules, always on the lookout for new toys, grabbed the snakes, tied them into a knot, and whirled them like a lasso. Then he sent them flying over the trees. Pain and Panic changed back into demons and limped off, vowing never to tell Hades that the baby was still alive. Of course, because of the potion, Hercules was no longer a god. But since he didn't drink the last drop, he still had godlike strength. Hercules went home to live with Amphitryon and Alcmene. As he grew into a young man, his strength also grew. There was just one small problem. He didn't know how to control it. Such as one day in the marketplace.
Hercules, slow down! Look out!
Whoa!
Oops, sorry, guys.
What a geek, destructo boy.
He's too dangerous to be around normal people.
Yeah, right. He didn't mean any harm. He's just a kid. He just can't control his strengths. Son, you shouldn't let those things they said back there get to you.
But Pop, they're right. I am a freak. I try to fit in. I really do. I just can't. Sometimes I feel like I really don't belong here. Like I'm supposed to be someplace else.
Hercules, son.
I know it doesn't make any sense.
I have often dreamed of a far-off place where a great warm welcome will be waiting for me, where the crowds will cheer when they see my face, and a voice keeps saying, "This is where I'm meant to be." I'll be there someday. If I can be strong, I know every mile will be worth my while. I would go most anywhere to feel like I belong.
That evening, Amphitryon and Alcmene told Hercules the story of how they had stumbled across him years ago.
But if you found me, then where did I come from? Why was I left here?
This was around your neck when we found you. It's the symbol of the gods.
This is it! Don't you see? Maybe they have the answers. I'll go to the Temple of Zeus and... Pop, you're the greatest parents anyone could have, but I gotta know.
Hercules kissed his parents goodbye.
I am on my way. I can go the distance. I don't care how far. Somehow I'll be strong. I know every mile will be worth my while. Go most anywhere to find where I belong.
Herc made his way to the Temple of Zeus, where he knelt before a giant statue of the god.
Almighty Zeus, please, hear me and answer my prayer. I need to know, who am I? Where do I belong?
There was a flash of lightning, and the statue came to life.
My boy, my little Hercules.
Hercules tried to run, but Zeus reached out and scooped him up in one palm.
Hey, hold on, kiddo, what's your hurry? After all these years, is this the kind of hello you give your father?
Father?
Didn't know you had a famous father, did you? Surprise!
But why did you leave me on Earth? Didn't you want me?
Of course we did. Your mother and I loved you with all our hearts, and someone stole you from us and turned you mortal. And only gods can live on Mount Olympus.
You can't do a thing?
I can't, Hercules, but you can.
Really? What? I'll do anything.
If you can prove yourself a true hero on Earth, your godhood will be restored.
A true hero? Great. Exactly how do you become a true hero?
First, you must seek out Philoctetes, the trainer of heroes.
Seek out Philoctetes. Right. I'll...
Hercules took one step and tumbled out of his father's hand. Zeus caught him in midair and set him gently on the ground.
Whoa! Hold your horses! Which reminds me... You probably don't remember Pegasus. But you two go way back, son.
Oh, Pegasus!
Hercules nuzzled the winged horse, then leaped onto his back and took off through the clouds.
I won't let you down, Father! Yee-haw!
Good luck, son.
I will beat the odds. I can go the distance. I will face the world. Fearless, proud, and strong. I will please the gods. I can go the distance till I find my hero's welcome.
Hercules flew to the island of Hydra, where he found Philoctetes, a strange-looking creature who was half-human, half-goat.
I need your help. I want to become a hero, a true hero.
Sorry, kid, can't help you.
Why not?
Two words. I am retired.
Look, I gotta do this. Haven't you ever had a dream? Something you wanted so bad you'd do anything?
Yeah, I had a dream once. I dreamed I was going to train the greatest hero there ever was. So great, the gods would hang a picture of him in the stars, all across the sky. And people would say, that's Phil's boy. That's right. Babbitt, dreams are for rookies. Guy can only take so much disappointment.
But if I don't become a true hero, I'll never be able to rejoin my father, Zeus.
Hold it. Zeus is your father, right? Zeus, the big guy, he's your daddy. Mr. Lightning Bolts. Zeus, once upon a time.
It's the truth.
Police. So you wanna be a hero, kid? Well, whoop-de-doo. I have been around the block before with blockheads just like you. Each and every one a disappointment, pain, ache, for which there ain't no ointment. So much for excuses. Now a kid of Zeus is asking me to jump into the fray. My answer is two words. Okay. Oh, you win. Oh, God. Baby. I've given up hope that someone would come along. A fella who ring the bell for once, not the gong. The kind who wins trophies, won't settle for low fees. At least semi-pro fees, but no. I get the greenhorn. I've been out to pasture pound my ambition gone. Content to spend lazy days and to graze my lawn. But you need an advisor, a sainer but wiser. A good merchandiser, and whoa! Here goes my ulcer! I'm down to one less hope, and I hope it's you. No kid, you're not exactly a dream come true. I trained enough turkeys who never came true. You're my one last hope, so you'll have to do. Ended up a mockery. Don't believe the stories that you read on all the crockery. To be a true hero, kid, is a dying art. Like painting a masterpiece, it's a work of heart. It takes more than sinew, comes down to what's in you. You have to continue to grow. Now that's more like it. I'm down to one last shot, and my last high note. Be before that blasted underworld gets my goat. My dreams are on you, kid. Go make them come true. Climb that uphill slope. Keep pushing that envelope. You're my one last hope. And kid, it's up to you.
And so Hercules went into training with Philoctetes. He did push-ups, chin-ups, aerobics. He practiced sword fighting, marksmanship, and rescuing damsels in distress. Seasons passed. Finally, Hercules gained precision and control to go with his godlike strength.
I am ready. I want to get off this island. I want to battle some monsters.
Rescue some damsels.
You know, heroic stuff.
Well, okay. You want a road test? Saddle up, kid. We're going to Thebes.
Yahoo!
They hopped onto Pegasus and took off toward the city of Thebes. On the way, they heard a sound from below.
Sounds like your basic DID. Damsel in distress!
They swooped down and saw a young woman being chased by the river guardian, Nessus. Nessus was a centaur. Half-horse, half-human creature. Hercules tried to rescue the woman, but she had other ideas.
I'm a damsel. I'm in distress. I can handle this. Have a nice day.
Ma'am, I'm afraid you may be too close to the situation to realize.
As Hercules was trying to explain, Nessus belted him in the jaw. Off to one side, Phil shouted encouragement.
Come on, kid, concentrate! Use your head!
So that's just what Hercules did. He lowered his head and charged straight towards the centaur, sending him flying into the river. Finally, with a tremendous blow, Hercules knocked him out cold.
Are you all right, Miss?
Megara. My friends call me Meg. At least they would if I had any friends. Are you always this articulate?
Hercules. My name is Hercules. Can we give you a ride?
I'll be all right. I'm a big, tough girl. I tie my own sandals and everything. Bye-bye, Wonder Boy.
She's something, isn't she, Phil?
Yeah, oh yeah. She's really something.
A real pain in the patella! Earth to her! Come in, Herc! We got a job to do, remember?
As they flew off toward Thebes, Meg wandered into the woods, where she met up with Pain, Panic, and Hades, Lord of the Underworld.
What exactly happened here? I thought you were going to persuade the River Guardian to join my team for the uprising, and here I am kind of River Guardian-less.
Look, it wasn't my fault. It was this Wonder Boy Hercules.
Hades stared at her, dumbfounded. Then he turned to Pain and Panic, shooting them a look that burned.
Hercules. Why does that name ring a bell?
Wait a minute. Wasn't Hercules the name of that kid we were supposed to?
Hades burst into flames and grabbed the two demons by their tails.
Oh, my God! Run for it!
I am about to rearrange the cosmos. And the one schlemiel who can loss it up is waltzing around in the woods!
At least we made him mortal. That's a good thing. Didn't we?
Fortunately for the three of you, we still have time to correct this rather egregious oversight. And this time, no foul-ups.
A short time later, Herc, Pegasus, and Phil rode into Thebes. It was a big, noisy city where something always seemed to be going wrong. First, there had been a huge fire, then an earthquake, then a flood, not to mention the crime rate. Hercules approached a group of unhappy citizens.
Excuse me. It seems to me that what you folks need is a hero.
Young man, we need a professional hero, not an amateur.
Well, wait, stop. How am I supposed to prove myself a hero if nobody will give me a chance?
You'll get your chance. You just need some kind of catastrophe or disaster.
Please, the help! Please! There's been a terrible accident!
Meg?
Speaking of disasters...
Outside of town, two little boys, they're playing in the gorge. There was this rock slide, a terrible rock slide. They're trapped.
Kids? Trapped? Phil, this is great!
Hercules jumped onto Pegasus, pulling Meg up with him.
No, I have this terrible fear of heights!
Pegasus, who had never liked Meg to begin with, just grinned and flew higher. Phil and the crowd, meanwhile, followed along on the ground. Soon all of them reached the deep canyon where the two boys were trapped.
Help! Get us out!
You're suffocating!
Easy, fellas. You'll be all right.
Gritting his teeth, Hercules lifted a huge boulder, freeing the two boys. They scampered up a hill where Hades was waiting. He grinned as they changed back into his two demons, Pain and Panic.
Stirring performance, boys. I was really moved.
Back in the gorge, Hercules noticed a hissing sound. It was coming from a cave that had been uncovered when he lifted the boulder. As he watched, the Hydra, a gigantic dragon-like monster, poked its head out of the cave.
What do you call that thing?
Two words! M-Scry!
Rather than running, Hercules hurled a giant boulder, which the Hydra caught in her mouth and crushed into gravel. Advancing on Hercules, the monster picked him up, flipped him into the air, and swallowed him. As the crowd watched in stunned silence, a bulge formed in the Hydra's neck. And out slashed a sword. Hercules struggled free, then with one final cut, he sliced off the monster's head.
All right, you bad, okay.
That doesn't sound good.
Definitely not good.
The monster rose up, and out of her neck, three new heads grew. When Hercules cut them off, nine heads grew back. Hercules kept cutting and cutting until he was faced with a 30-headed monster.
Will you forget the head-slicing thing?
Pinning Hercules to the cliff, the monster closed in for the kill. Hades looked on gleefully.
My favorite part of the game. Sudden death.
As the Hydra's 30 heads positioned for a final strike, Hercules reared back and smashed his fist into the mountainside. Tons of boulders cascaded down the cliff, burying the monster. But they also buried Hercules. Hades grinned.
Game, set, match.
Just then, something stirred in the rubble. The Hydra's clenched claw was forced open, and Hercules emerged. The crowd went wild.
You did it, kid! You did it! You won by a landslide!
Overnight, Hercules became the most famous person in Thebes. And his fame grew as he defeated one monster after another, sent by Hades to destroy him. There were Herc t-shirts, Herc shoes, and Herc mugs. Everyone was thrilled, except for Hades.
Looks like your game's over. Wonder Boy's hitting every curve you throw at him.
I wonder if maybe I haven't been throwing the right curves at him, Meg, my sweet.
Don't even go there.
See, he's got to have a weakness, because everybody's got a weakness. You give me the key to bringing down Wonder Breath, and I give you the thing that you crave most in the entire cosmos, your freedom.
While Hades schemed, Hercules returned to the Temple of Zeus, where he told his father what had happened.
You're doing great, son. You're doing your old man proud.
I'm glad to hear you say that, Father. I've been waiting for this day a long time.
What day is that, son?
The day I rejoined the gods.
You've done wonderfully. You really have, my boy. You're just not there yet. I'm afraid being famous isn't the same as being a true hero.
But how can I...
Look inside your heart.
In a flash of lightning, Zeus turned back into a statue.
Now that Hercules was famous, Phil had big plans for him. There were product endorsements, interviews, statues, and souvenir vases. Teenage girls followed him screaming wherever he went. One day, they came right to his house, and he hid behind a curtain. When the girls left and the screaming faded away, one voice remained.
Let's see, what could be behind curtain number one?
Meg!
So this is what heroes do on their days off.
I know, it's crazy. You know, I can't go anywhere without being mobbed. I mean...
You sound like you could use a break. Think your nanny goat would go berserk if you played hooky this afternoon?
Oh, gee, I don't know. Phil's got the rest of the day pretty much booked.
Ah, Phil Schmill. Just follow me out the window, around the dumbbells. You lift up the back wall and we're gone.
They spent the whole day together, ending up in a large, beautiful garden. When Hercules looked away, two birds landed next to Meg. They were pain and panic, bringing a message from their master.
Psst! Stop fooling around!
Yeah, get the goods, sister!
As they flew away, Meg pretended to stumble.
Oh, whoops. Oh,
careful.
Sorry. Weak ankles.
Oh, yeah.
So, do you have any problems with things like this? No weaknesses whatsoever? No trick knee, ruptured discs?
No. I'm afraid I'm fit as fiddle.
Wonder Boy, you are perfect.
Meg, when I'm with you, I don't feel so alone.
Sometimes it's better to be alone.
What do you mean?
Nobody can hurt you.
Meg, I would never, ever hurt you.
And I don't want to hurt you, so let's both do ourselves a favor and stop this before we...
All right, break it up! Break it up! Party's over! I've been looking all over this town!
Calm down, Mutton Man. It was all my fault.
You're already on my list, sister, so don't make it worse. And as for you, you bum, you're gonna go to the stadium, and you're gonna be put through the work out of your life. Now get on the horse.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Meg watched sadly as Hercules climbed onto Pegasus with Phil and flew off. No one noticed when Phil's head struck a tree branch on takeoff, and he fell to the ground unconscious. Nearby, Meg gazed into the reflecting pool and called on the muses for advice and help.
What's the matter with me? You'd think a girl would learn. If there's a prize for rotten judgment, I guess I've already won. No man is worth the aggravation. That's ancient history. Been there, done that.
Don't you think you're kidding? He's the earth and heaven. Do you try to keep it hidden? Honey, we can see right through your garden.
I won't say I'm in love.
you're dying to cry your heart out.
When Meg looked up from the reflecting pool, Hades was standing beside her.
Hey, what's the buzz, huh, Meg?
What is the weak link in Wonder Boy's chain?
Get yourself another girl, I'm through.
Meg, my sweet, deluded little minion.
Aren't we forgetting one teensy-weensy but ever so crucial little tiny detail?
I own you! Behind the bushes, Phil woke up with a lump on his head. Hearing voices, he peeked through the branches and saw Meg and Hades.
You work for me. If I say sing, you say, hey, name that tune. If I say I want Wonder Boy's head on a platter, you say...
medium or well done.
Oh, I knew that dame was trouble. This is gonna break the kid's heart.
Phil raced off to tell Hercules. If he had stayed a moment longer, he would have learned how Meg really felt.
I don't care. I'm not going to help you hurt him.
I can't believe you're getting so worked up about some guy.
This one is different. He's honest and he's sweet.
Please.
He would never do anything to hurt me. Besides, oh, oneness, you can't beat him. He has no weaknesses. He's gonna...
She stopped. Because Hades was staring at her, grinning.
I think he does, Meg. I truly think he does.
Across town, Phil found Hercules working out at the stadium.
Kid, we gotta talk.
Oh, Phil, I just had the greatest day of my life. I can't stop thinking about Meg. She's something else.
Hercules, in a playful mood, began circling round Phil, pretending to throw punches.
Will you just knock it off for a couple of seconds?
Phil, I got two words for you. Duck.
Listen to me, she's...
a dream come true?
She's a fraud! She's been playing you for a sap!
Oh, come on, stop kidding around.
She's none but a two-time...
Stop it!
No good, lying, scheming...
Shut up!
Herc angrily spun around and shoved Phil. It was just a little push, but still it was strong enough to send Phil flying across the stadium where he landed with a crash.
Phil, I'm sorry.
Okay, that's it. You won't face the truth? Fine.
Phil, wait, where you going?
I'm hopping the first barge out of here. I'm going home.
Fine! Go!
I don't need you.
I thought you were going to be the all-time champ. Not the all-time chump.
As Phil limped off, Hercules turned and saw Hades perched on the goalposts.
Jeez Louise, what got his goat, huh? Name is Hades, Lord of the Dead. Hi, how you doing?
Not now, okay?
Hey, I only need a few seconds, and I'm a fast talker, all right? See, I've got this major deal in the works, a real estate venture, if you will. And Herc, your little W, may I call you Herc? You seem to be constantly getting in the way of it,
you've got the wrong guy.
Just hear me out, okay? So I would be eternally grateful if you would just take a day off from this hero business of yours. Jeez, I mean, monsters, natural disasters, they can wait a day.
You're out of your mind.
Not so fast, because you see, I do have a little leverage you might want to know about.
Hades snapped his fingers, and Meg appeared, bound in chains.
Meg! Let her go!
So, here's the trade-off. You give up your strength for about 24 hours, okay? Say the next 24 hours, and Meg here is free as a bird and safe from harm. We dance, we kiss, we schmooze, we carry on, we go home happy. What do you say? Come on.
To show he meant business, Hades tightened Meg's chains.
I really don't have, like, time to bat this around. I'm kind of on a schedule. I've got plans for August, okay? I need an answer, like, now. Going once, going twice.
All right.
Yes, we're there! Bam!
As they shook hands, all the color and strength drained from Hercules. Hades tossed a barbell, and it pinned Herc to the ground.
Now you know how it feels to be just like everybody else. Isn't it just peachy? Oh, you'll love this. One more thing. Meg, babe, a deal's a deal. You're off the hook.
What do you mean?
I mean your little tricky poo here was working for me all the time. Duh.
No, it's not like that. I didn't mean to. I couldn't. I'm so sorry.
Hercules stared at her. Hades, meanwhile, hopped into a chariot and rode off over the ocean. As he did, the planets came into alignment. The seas parted, revealing a gaping pit where giant creatures called Titans were imprisoned years before by Zeus. Hades looked down at them with an evil grin.
Brothers! Titans! Look at you in your squalid prison! Who put you down there? And now that I set you free, what is the first thing you are going to do?
Destroy him!
As the Titans scaled Mount Olympus, the guards grabbed their weapons, jumped into chariots, and the battle began. At the same time, Hades has sent the Cyclops, a giant one-eyed monster, off to destroy Thebes and lure Hercules into a showdown.
Hercules! Come out! Face me!
Not knowing he had lost his strength, the people of Thebes cheered when Hercules appeared. But the Cyclops just laughed.
So, you mighty Hercules!
He punched and kicked and pounded Hercules. The once mighty hero was too weak to resist. Meg, watching in horror, hurried off to look for Pegasus. She found him in a stable where pain and panic had tied him up.
Listen, Hercules is in trouble. We've got to find Phil. He's the only one who can talk some sense into him.
She freed the horse, and together they flew to the harbor, where Phil was just getting onto a boat to leave Thebes.
Phil, Hercules needs your help.
What does he need me for when he's got friends like you?
Look, I know what I did was wrong, but this isn't about me, it's about him. If you don't help him now, Phil, he'll die.
On Mount Olympus, the Titans were unstoppable. They captured one guard after another. Finally, they encased Zeus in a mountain of frozen lava. He looked up to see Hades riding in on his chariot.
Zeusy, I'm home!
Hades, you're behind this?
You're correct, sir!
Meanwhile, in Thebes, the Cyclops was about to finish off Hercules when Pegasus arrived, carrying Meg and Phil.
Come on, kid. Come on. Fight back.
You were right all along, Phil. Dreams are for rookies.
No, kid. Giving up is for rookies. I came back because I'm not quitting on you. I'm willing to go the distance. How about you?
Just then, the Cyclops scooped up Hercules. On the way up, Hercules grabbed a burning timber and waved it near the Cyclops' eye. Then Herc tripped the monster with a rope. The Cyclops stumbled over a cliff and fell into the sea. But on the way, he hit a large column and it toppled towards Hercules.
Hercules, look out!
Meg pushed him aside, only to have the column land on top of her.
Meg! No!
As Hercules tried to lift the column, his strength began to return.
What's happening?
Hades' deal is broken. He promised I wouldn't get hurt.
Hercules threw the column aside, but Meg was badly injured. Hercules bent over her.
You haven't got much time. You can still stop Hades.
I'll watch over her, kid.
You're gonna be all right. I promise.
Hercules leaped onto Pegasus and went riding off. On Mount Olympus, Hades had captured all the gods, including Zeus.
I swear to you, Hades, when I get out of this.
I'm the one giving orders now, Bolt Boy, and I think I'm gonna like it here.
Don't get too comfortable, Hades! Hercules!
Before Hades could stop him, Hercules freed his father and the other gods.
Thank you, my boy.
Ah! Now, watch your old man work!
Zeus hurled a lightning bolt at the rock titan, shearing off one of his heads. When the wind titan attacked, Hercules grabbed him by the tail and used him as a vacuum to suck up the rest of the titans. Then Hercules whirled them over his head and sent them flying off into space. Hades, seeing that the tide had turned, hopped into his chariot.
Thanks a ton, Wonder Boy, but at least I've got one small consolation prize. A friend of yours who's dying to see me.
Meg. Hercules and Pegasus flew back to Thebes. There he found Meg lying motionless in Phil's arms. She was dead.
Meg, no.
Oh, I'm sorry, kid. There's some things you just can't change.
Yes, I can.
Far below, in the depths of the underworld, Hades was in a rage. Pain and panic cowered nearby.
We were so close!
So close. We tripped at the finish line. Why? Because our little nutmeg has to go all noble.
Suddenly Hercules burst in.
Look who's here.
Where's Meg?
Hades led Hercules to a high ledge. Down below, the spirits of the dead floated around a pit of death. One of them was Meg.
You like making deals. Take me in Meg's place.
The son of my hated rival trapped forever in a river of death.
Going once.
Is there a downside to this?
Going twice.
Okay. You get her out. She goes. You stay.
Hercules dived into the pit and made his way toward Meg.
You know what slipped my mind? You'll be dead before you can get to her. Is that a problem?
As pain and panic looked on, Hercules began growing older by the second. When he finally reached Meg, he was thin, weak, and very old. Still, he reached out for her. As their hands touched, an amazing thing happened. His flesh began to grow, fill out, and look young, and a glow surrounded his body.
This is impossible! You can't be alive. You'd have to be a god?
Hercules made his way out, carrying Meg's spirit.
Hercules, stop! You can't do this to me! You can't!
Rearing back, Hercules threw a tremendous punch, sending Hades down into the pit of death. Hercules took Meg's spirit back to Thebes and gently reunited it with her lifeless form. Her eyes fluttered, and she woke up as Hercules embraced her A cloud formed beneath them, lifting them into the air and up to Mount Olympus, where Zeus and Hera were waiting, along with the other gods.
Fine work, my boy. You've done it. You're a true hero.
You were willing to give your life to rescue this young woman.
Now at last, my son, you can come home.
Father, this is the moment I've always dreamed of. But a life without Meg, even an immortal life, would be empty. I wish to stay on Earth with her. I finally know where I belong.
Hercules kissed Meg and said goodbye to his parents. As the happy couple made their way back to their friends and family on Earth, Zeus reached into the sky, grabbed a handful of stars, and flung them to the heavens, where they formed a new constellation of Hercules. And to this day, whenever people see that constellation, it reminds them that a true hero isn't measured by the size of his strength, but by the strength of his heart.
A shout from the mountain tops.
A star is born.
It's a time for pulling out the stars.